Hello and welcome to Creative Sparkle. My name's Holly and today we're doing an art journal prompt list. So grab your art supplies and let's get crafting. Hello and thank you for joining me today. So we're working in a normal sketchbook today with just the one page, and I'm just wanting to put that masking tape down the side of those ring binders just to make sure that we have a nice clean edge. So the first prompt is to scrunch and crunch tissue paper or masking tape and add as the base. So I'm going to be using Mod Podge to add the tissue paper down onto the page, and I'm just going to try and make sure the creases are included. So going over the top of the tissue paper as well with that Mod Podge, just to make sure those creases, you can see them coming through. You can choose whatever colour that you like, whatever medium that you like. If only masking tape is what you have, or you could use normal paper if that's what you have, just scrunch it up. And with the masking tape, obviously, if you wanted to use that, you don't need to use glue to stick it down because it's already got glue on it. But if you're using normal paper, just try and stick that down. You could use the glue stick if that's what you have available to you. So whatever you have. So prompt number two is to do a rubbing of the base to emphasize the creases of your spread. Now I'm using Gelato. I'm just using the blue one, which I believe the colour is named Cotton Candy. And I've taken the middle out of the actual plastic casing and I'm just rubbing it on the side of the Gelato. If you have oil pastels, you could use that, or normal crayons. Everyone has crayons in the house, especially if there's children around. So whatever you have. And then we'll move on to prompt number three, which is to change or add colour to a mesh and add it to the page. So I have this Hessian material and it's got a backing of paper on it. So I'm just going to stick those down onto the page, just randomly over the page and in a kind of organised pattern. And then once I've stuck those down, I'm going to use a distress ink in peacock feathers to add some colour to them. So rather than painting them before sticking them down or trying to add colour to them prior, I stuck them down with gel medium first. And then I will use, broken china to go over it. And I'm just going to splatter over those little shapes just so that we've got some colour going over them there. You could add colour fully if you wanted to, even before you put the mesh or whatever you have available to you down. So moving on to prompt number four, we're going to add a few groups of something to enhance the background. So I've chosen to use a circle punch. It's an inch circle punch, and I've got this watercolour paper, which I got from the pound shop. It's a pad of paper and it's coloured with watercolours. So I've chosen a few colours of blue shade in those punches, and I'm going to use some pearl drops in pastel clear, as you can see here. So this I would probably compare to glossy accents, if that's probably what people normally use in this case. But this one's a cheaper version and it dries a bit thicker. So when it dries, it doesn't take the shape of what you're using. It kind of still has the texture there. So you'll be able to see that once they've dried. So once I've finished that, I'll put them on the page in groups, as you can see here. And then I'll stick them down with some glue dots that I have in my drawer. They are supposed to look like bubbles, that's why I chose the circles, because I thought it kind of looked like it was an undersea project. I don't know why, but you just choose something that you have available and that goes with your page. So prompt number five is to add some mystical elements to the page. I don't know if I read this wrong or if I just decided that seahorses were mystical, but that's what I've chosen to add to my page. I just had some paper available and I cut them out on the Scan and Cut that I have. It's a cutout shape that's already on there. It's not something I've accumulated from anywhere. And I'm just going to stick them down with some Mod Podge. You can choose anything that you like to go on that prompt. So the next prompt is prompt number six, which is to choose or create a focal image that's inspired by one of the elements, so earth, air, fire or water. And I've chosen this seahorse that I had from a colouring book, and I'm just going to use felt tip pens to colour it in. And I won't make you watch the whole thing, don't worry, but I've chosen four colours to colour it in. And I'll skip over that in a moment. Now, unfortunately, there is another prompt that I completely missed. I must have skipped over it somehow. But add one or more pieces of ephemera relating to the focal image chosen. Unfortunately, I completely missed that. And to be fair, the page is really busy anyway, so it probably wouldn't have fit. So going on to prompt number 8, which is to put glitter on the page somewhere. So I'll move straight on to this prompt. If obviously ever you want to add something or not do one of the prompts, then that's great, that's fine. Whatever you feel is going with your page. The whole idea of the prompt list is just to take your mind off trying to figure out what to put down next. So just go with it, go with the flow. I'm quite glad actually that I've missed one, because it goes to show that it's all customizable. So the 9th prompt is to find a mystical quote or title and add it to the page. So I've got this card that I had and some stickers dash, and rather than using a quote, I just got a title, which is the Greek word for seahorse, which I thought was quite apt. So I'm just sticking the pink stickers down onto the green paper because I thought they went quite well with my page, and they're both very glittery, which fits in with the glitter that I added. So hippocampus is the Greek name for the seahorse, and now that that's all cut out, I'm just going to use some Mode Lawn Distress Ink and an ink pad and add a little border around the title just to make it stand out a bit more, and add that to the page again with some gel medium. And then once that's added, we'll move on to the 10th and final prompt, which is to add a subtle border to your page. So I actually just chose to go again with the Mode Lawn and the blending tool and just go around the edges of my page. So once that's done, that's the end of the page, and I'll put the full prompt list at the end of the video just so that you can take a screenshot and do the prompt list if you like. If you do decide to take part in the prompt list, please do tag me on Instagram with the hashtag SparklePrompts. And if you enjoyed the video, please press the like button and subscribe for the next time. And I will see you next time, where we will turn your creative spark into creative sparkle. Thanks. Bye.